What I'm saying is that this is the period from 11,600 years ago today. This is the period when the whole story of human civilization as it is taught to us supposedly unfolds. And we have this huge interruption before it called the Younger Dryas and these cataclysmic events at the end of the last ice age. And my suggestion is that the myths are true and that there was an earlier civilization and that we are a species with amnesia and that the destruction was so massive and so global in its extent and so cataclysmic in its form that we did have to begin again like children.
12,500 years ago, humanity was struck down by a catastrophic event that brought the Ice Age into a sudden and violent end. The comet impacts upon the ice glaciers caused massive floods, which rose the sea levels by 400 feet, submerging the coastal lines entirely. The fallout from the impact blocked out the sun. The Earth then entered a 1,500-year period of frozen hell. If such an event were to occur now, what would the result be? We already know that the world elitists have prepared for such events with their underground cities and their space programs. The rich would either flee the planet or take shelter, while everyone else would be left high and dry. I wonder if it would be a situation where those who escaped would return to Earth, perhaps decades or centuries later, once it stabilizes, only to find the descendants of the survivors to be living in a primitive state. Generations without power, electricity, technology, or education, humans would live no different from the tribal peoples that we see around the world today. Perhaps a situation like this is not too far off of what actually happened to our species. Around the world, from Mesopotamia, Egypt, to Mesoamerica, are accounts of beings who brought agriculture and science to the inhabitants of the area. They are described by the primitives as gods. Despite the disconnection between all these cultures, the depictions and descriptions of these figures are identical. These figures are known as the Nine Netaru, Osiris, Viracocha, Quetzalcoatl, the Anunnaki. They are all known to have imparted knowledge to the people. We find that the iconography and the features of these figures are identical in every culture that depicts them. Cultures that we now know are connected to this lost civilization.
That we did have to begin again like children, with no memory of what went before, or perhaps a little memory that was passed down by survivors who established locations all around the world, Giza, in Indonesia, in South America, in Turkey.
Cultures that share the same architecture as well as the same system of knowledge.
Quetzalcoatl, Osiris, and the Nagas are all said to have come from the sea to bring knowledge and agriculture to the people.
The Anunnaki of Mesopotamia appear throughout the ancient religions of the Sumerians, Akkadians, Assyrians, and Babylonians, all described as sky gods, who share similar features, specifically bearded men, all-knowing and all-wise. This is significant considering the fact that Quetzalcoatl was also depicted as a bearded man.
And of course the Easter Island figures are bearded. You can see it quite clearly on some of the statues. If we excavate them as Thor Heyerdahl did in the 1950s, we find that those statues don't just stick a few feet above the ground, but actually go down 30 feet beneath the ground. And what Robert Schock's recent study at Easter Island has shown is that that is sedimentation. And there's just no way that you get that 30 feet of sedimentation in 700 years. It's thousands and thousands of years of sedimentation. And we have bearded men in Tiwanaku associated with the civilizing deity Viracocha, who came in a time of darkness to reestablish civilization after a global cataclysm.
Considering the fact that these figures around the world are attributed to the advancement of these civilizations, it is clear, based off all that we have researched and uncovered so far, that these figures are the survivors of the lost civilization who sought out to help reboot and restart mankind. This explains why these seemingly scattered and unconnected civilizations share the same iconography, method of architecture, processional alignments, and recognition of sacred geometry. It is why the oldest religions of today's world are only 6,480 years old. Our species survived the cataclysm, resettled in different places around the world, and generations later, we're back to living in hunter-gatherer societies. The other survivors
who took shelter, who had the means to preserve their knowledge and understanding and technology, returned to the lands to help reboot mankind, gradually teaching them the old ways.
That's what I think Göbekli Tepe is. I think it's a place that was established by the survivors of a lost civilization. That's why the agricultural revolution begins there suddenly overnight, just at the time that those Göbekli Tepe megaliths are being created, just after the cataclysm that caused the Younger Dryas to set in. That's when we get the origins of agriculture. Sudden innovation in agriculture takes place. It looks like it's an innovation that was done by people who already knew how to do agriculture, who were doing it somewhere else.